talk about stores closings, there is very little about stores opening. And when we actually look at the national retail data in 2017, it was actually a net positive of a stores opening of 4,000 just in the US.
We will continue to survive because people like human-to-human experiences. And if we let these stores just rot and we don't replace them and we don't think about how the culture of the people that work there cares about the people that are walking in, then they'll go away.
80% of consumers, to your point, are telling that they want to continue to buy in stores. And that data is 5 times higher in the Gen Zs and millennials.
Le consommateur américain recherche quand même une expérience dans les magasins, la possibilité de découvrir des choses nouvelles. Et on voit de plus en plus les magasins proposer des expériences aux consommateurs qui vont les attirer.
On a innové en fait avec un nouveau concept magasin, un concept qui est plus chaleureux, plus on-brand, comme on dit, représentatif de la marque, et aussi un concept qui intègre de la personnalisation, qui est un élément clé aujourd'hui du retail aux US. Ça nous a donné un nouveau souffle, et évidemment, ça a drivé du business en plus dans les magasins qui en bénéficient.
De plus en plus de marchands vont essayer de mettre en place des solutions de paiement mobile à l'intérieur des magasins, un peu comme ce que vous avez dans les Apple Store. Vous n'avez plus de caisses dans les Apple Store. Donc les caisses ne vont pas disparaître du jour au lendemain, mais vous allez avoir de plus en plus de surface de vente qui va être consacrée en fait à l'exposition des produits, et vous allez avoir en fait des paiements qui vont se faire de plus en plus en mobilité en magasin, en accompagnement du consommateur.
It was one of the best holiday seasons in retail for many, many years, and so retail is definitely not dead in America, and it's definitely not dead around the world. There must be a significant closure of retail stores. Macy's closed 20% of their stores 2 years ago with a purposeful look about to the future. Every one of those stores was cash flow positive, every one of them. But looking out into the future, we knew we had too many. When America realizes that they have too many and they get that reduced to the right level, supply and demand will return, stores will grow again on a comp level once again, and there will be that balance of one look by the consumer of online and in the physical store together.
So I see two requirements for retailers. They're going to have to up their game when it comes to digital experience. In the stores, they're doing very well. You see a lot of restaurants, yoga classes, etc. Online, it's still very weak. Number two, with data privacy and personalization, they're going to have to find ways to capture smart data, behavioral data, in an aggregated way.